I'm sorry it has to end this way, brother.
Picking up right where the search left off, Zuko, along with Ursa, Ikum, and Kiyi, were making their grand return to the Fire Nation, escorted by the Kyoshi Warriors. But back home, a conspiracy was taking shape. One night, Ukano was woken by Kimura Kaji, dark spirits fabled as kidnappers of children. These spirits delivered a warning to Ukano: depose the Fire Lord, or no Fire Nation family will be safe. Ukano rallied his followers of the new Ozai Society. Since Ozai's imprisonment, they've secretly and patiently plotted to overthrow Zuko. Now, Ukano decided to accelerate their plans.
Take them out.
It's Mei.
In the midst of battle, Ukano confronted Mei, his daughter. He tried justifying his actions to her, claiming Zuko was too weak to be Fire Lord and must be removed. Mei thought he was insane, but despite his beliefs, she let her father escape. When Ukano's men fled, Zuko and his family returned to the palace safely. Kiyi and Ikum couldn't have been more excited for their new home. But Ursa was terrified. A cold shiver came down Ursa's spine. She realized her family was being hunted by people loyal to him, the monster that banished her. Over a month had passed, and all was quiet. There had been several reports of the Kimura Kaji snatching unsuspecting children, including Mei's brother Tom Tom. If they were going against spirits, they'd need the Avatar's help. Back in Ba Sing Se, Aang received Zuko's call for aid. Katara and Sokka were already headed for the South Pole to see their father. For now, the team needed to split up.
I'm sorry, Katara.
It's okay. I'm really proud of you.
Aang swiftly returned to the Fire Nation, where he reunited with Zuko, Mei, and met her new boyfriend, Kalo. Mei told Aang about the Kimura Kaji. They were supposed to be just an old wives' tale, but they were very real and very dangerous. The Fire Sage's temple seemed to be the best place to learn more about these mysterious spirits. Down in the catacombs, they traced the Kimura Kaji all the way back to the very first Fire Lord. According to the legend, the Kimura Kaji were spirits of mothers whose children were abducted by ancient warlords. They haunted the warlords by taking their families away, one child at a time. But they have been dormant for hundreds of years, and eventually just became a ghost story. Deep in the temple, one of the original Kimura Kaji appeared, and she revealed a startling truth. They hadn't set foot in the human world since the reign of the first Fire Lord. But that was centuries ago, meaning they couldn't have taken Tom Tom. If the spirits aren't taking the kids, then who is? Whoever they were back. And they got Kiyi.
Get away from us!
Ah!
Azula!
All of the kidnapped children were taken to an underground bunker, and Kiyi was their latest addition. Unmasked, these Chimera Kaji were just Azula and her friends from the asylum. Azula broke them out and plotted the entire conspiracy with Ukano. Ukano helped Azula organize the kidnappings, thus bringing fear and panic to Fire Nation citizens. His efforts to overthrow Zuko came at a cost. He had done everything Azula asked and demanded the children be released. But Azula wasn't as eager to release the kids as Ukano was, knowing they would lead Zuko straight to her. She trapped them and Ukano in the bunker with no way to escape.
I gotta pee.
But luckily, Kiyi had one little trick up her sleeve. Meanwhile, Team Avatar was still trying to find the missing children. Their search led them to a mysterious cemetery outside of the capital.
It's great to see you, Mei. Do you really want to fight me?
Back off, Azula!
You're hilarious.
Get back here!
Suddenly, Aang heard cries for help inside one of the crypts. It was Ukano and the kids! Back on the surface, Zuko followed Azula into one of the crypts.
I was wondering when you'd show up, Zuzu.
This wasn't the same Azula from the last time they fought. She was cool, calm, collected, ready to take on her brother once more.
You want a show? I'll give you a show.
But this time, Azula wasn't trying to become Fire Lord. She wanted Zuko to become her type of Fire Lord, one who ruled with fear. Azula wanted to awaken the tyrant living inside Zuko. Then, in a sense, she would become Fire Lord again.
Goodbye, Zuko.
Before Zuko could stop her, she escaped without a trace. The following day, Ukano was arrested for his conspiracy with Azula. Zuko addressed the citizens of the Fire Nation. With Aang at his side, he admitted his response against the Chimera Kaji was disappointing, and he resolved to do better as Fire Lord. For now, there was an uneasy peace in the Fire Nation. Back at the palace, Iroh helped Ursa gain the courage to face her fears and confront Ozai. Upon seeing him in his cell, Ursa realized she had nothing to fear anymore. She was the prisoner during their marriage. Now, it was his turn. That wraps up Smoke and Shadow. Which comic should we recap next? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for all things Avatar.